Welcome to RoboFest 2002 at Lawrence Tech University.
Students and coaches started arriving early at Riddler Fieldhouse. Coaches registered their teams as students began setting up their computers and testing their robots. Coaches, parents, family, and fans started to fill up the bleachers. RoboFest is an open event sponsored by Lawrence Tech and Blue Cross Blue Shield. Students statewide come together to display their high-tech robots. This year's competition was entitled Robo Rescuers and dedicated to the brave efforts of firefighters, police officers, and emergency rescue teams all over the world. The task was to save people stuck at the top of a burning building by supplying them with oxygen masks and then transporting them back to safety. The competition required the efforts of two robots, each designed to perform specialized tasks. The first robot had to transport and deliver oxygen masks to the second robot. Upon receiving the gas masks, the second robot had to proceed up a steep incline, remove a wall of debris in its way, and then rescue the people at the top, and finally turn around and return to safety at the bottom of the ramp. When we first watch RoboFest, it looks easy, but building, programming, and racing robots requires special people with special attributes and skills. Seymour Papert, the former chairman of the MIT Media Lab, states, "We learn better by doing. We learn better still if we combine our doing with talking and thinking about what we have done." So successful robot builders must be able to communicate with others and utilize other people's knowledge. In short, it takes teamwork to build something as complicated as a robot. Successful robot builders must have vision and imagination. They must be able to imagine how they want their robot to work and then visualize how they are going to go about building it. Successful robot builders must have clarity. They must be able to identify the task and then develop a strategy for completing the task. They must be able to take that strategy and implement it into a meaningful design that they can actually build with the materials they have. Successful robot builders are problem solvers. They constantly hypothesize and experiment to test each hypothesis. Trial and error only works if they have the ability to analyze what went wrong and have the imagination to think how they might fix what went wrong. Dr. Papert refers to students using the Mindstorms robotics kits as special kinds of learners. They think in the abstract, but are able to play with a limited set of concrete tools and through the use of their imagination apply these tools to solve practical problems. He refers to them as tinkerers and says they remind him of the old handyman. If robot building requires such hard work and is so frustrating, why do students do it? Take a quick look at this year's finals and see if you can tell why.
We got all four going strong this time. Four, four on its way back. Craig Three just knocks it off.
RoboFest contestants experience a sense of excitement. A sense of accomplishment. A sense of pride. A sense of satisfaction. A sense of confidence. And a sense of camaraderie. One robot builder, when asked to describe what it was like to build a robot, said, "It was hard. Hard fun." And perhaps that's what best describes what learning should be. Challenging, yet fun. And that certainly does describe RoboFest. This event required many, many volunteers, judges, interviewers, timekeepers, audiovisual workers, award makers, camera crew, financial aid, registration workers, and many, many other jobs.
WXYZ 7. Now, Action News.
For they may be the rescue workers of the future. This aided as they try to quickly rescue Lego citizens from a burning building. The robots are roughly the size of a large shoebox, and they use their robotic strength to remove concrete walls that are trapping victims. 258 students are competing in this year's RoboFest at Lawrence Tech. A lot of interesting robots there.
My daughter loves Legos, but she's not quite advanced to that point
to
yet.
To do that just no, yet. Give yet. Her a few years. She'll be ready.
And we're very pleased to welcome today a new sponsor, the Reese Organization, which is a web-based, web development, software development company, who've given us support and sponsorship for this event. Godfrey Nolan, the principal of the firm. Thank you so much.
When using this robot, the patient has less chance of scarring, quicker healing time, and less blood loss.
Neurosurgery is the treatment of diseases and disorders in the brain and the nervous system. Our robot, the neurologist, specializes in surgery of the brain.
Two, one, off. at speed over here. The Robo Kids. Gravity Hip-Hop.